time for Beauty Buzz, and this is Buzzworthy this morning. Before you finish up that makeup, do you actually know the ingredients that you are putting on your face? Soraya and Tara are here to show us maybe a better option and what we need to avoid. Girls, I don't think about it. I don't think I look at ingredients when it comes to makeup. Maybe you do at the grocery store, but not in your personal care products. Are they regulated?
And it's not just makeup. It's all products. Right. All products. Hair, deodorant, all of it. So
shampoo,
when we
conditioner,
talk about it, think about everything makeup, that we are right. using. Everything that touches our skin, yeah. our hair, anything.
Skincare, everything.
So girls, mm-hmm. harmful possibly for us, harmful yes. for the environment? What are we talking about?
The reality is most Americans have no idea about the toxic, harmful chemicals that they're putting onto their bodies every single day. We as a society are, we're healthy, we work out, we are eating organic, we have a green smoothie every single day, but yet we walk into our normal stores and we're unknowingly putting endocrine disrupting, harmful carcinogens onto our bodies every single day.
And not just our own, right. our children.
Right.
Our husbands, our families, you know.
The largest organ of our body is our skin. Mm-hmm. And it takes 26 seconds for an ingredient to hit your bloodstream. And here's the thing. The lack of regulation in the personal care industry is appalling. The last time a law has been placed to protect our health and safety from the ingredients inside of our personal care products is 1938.
And there's 80,000 chemicals that have not been tested.
Yep.
So this is a conversation.
This is 80 years.
I know that Kourtney yes, Kardashian right. has been yes, very vocal exactly. about what right. is in your makeup, doing clean makeup. Are there ingredients we should be avoiding? What should we do about this if we're frustrated?
There's a lot of ingredients we should be avoiding that are in our ingredients. And so this is why we've really created Safer Beauty Bar. It's more of an educational platform. It's an event. It's an awareness. It's a movement for men and women that we can come together and we can share this information and share this knowledge and share solutions that we found that are effective, that are safe for ourselves, safer for ourselves, and safer for
our
children.
You know, it's not just our products that are in the grocery stores. It's professional products as
right.
well that are on the same, you know, have
well, girls, do we need to search out safer products or do we need
yes.
to hope for more legislation?
Or both. We need to
yes.
do both. And so that's what we're doing. You know, our hope is, and let me kind of start here too. So since 1938, since World War II, an influx of chemicals have hit us. More mm-hmm. than 85,000 chemicals have come into our society. Less than 20%, and some would say less than 10%, have been tested for safety on human health. That's really scary, really scary. And so the European Union, they're sort of taking the lead in this fight for safer beauty, where they have almost 1,400 toxic chemicals in their personal care products, which, by the way, some of our very commonly found, and I'm not gonna say name brands here, but commonly found shampoos, conditioners, name brands or companies, I should say, they actually changed the formula to meet safety standards in European Union versus here in the United States. The United States
really?
Has only banned, in fact, the United States has only banned 30, not 30,000.
30.
And 30, 30.
Hiding these
yes.
is under the word fragrance. So you're picking things up.
Fragrance is a big one, yes.
Fragrance.
It's like number one, fragrance number two.
Yes.
And you have no idea what that
means. They're hiding a lot of stuff because of, you know, proprietary reasons underneath the word fragrance. In fact, if you haven't watched the documentary on Netflix yet called Stink, I highly recommend you doing it. It's brand new. It talks about everything that we're talking about right now.
And your detergents.
Yep.
Ladies, what are these products right here? Are these clean products?
These are safer products. These are all European standards. In fact, some of them are more than that. And we love these companies because they advocate for safer beauty. They're effective. They're innovative. And it's really hard to find safer products out there that really actually work, which is really exciting about these products.
Well, you need to be educated. And if our viewers out there want to know more, what should they do?
They can reach us at www.saferbeautybar.com.
Right.
We also have an Instagram. We have a Facebook.
Follow us on Instagram.
It's all
right.
Safer Beauty Bar. We also do
events.
We're doing an event at Bra Bar Boutique this Saturday from 2 to 6.
Yep.
We will be there showing you how to do like a smoky eye or your hair products, but also giving you other options, deodorants,
right. toothpaste,
feminine hygiene products.
Right.
Everything is affected by this.
Right.
not just your skin products.
You can also go to our website to find out all of the resources. Actually, just click on resources where you can find all this information that we've shared, and probably even more. And I would warn you, once you go down this rabbit hole,
you kind of can't unlearn it.
You can't unlearn this information. It's like taking the blue pill or the red pill.
I will warn you.
I will warn you. But it's information that we are so passionate about. We are so compelled to share it with everybody.
I like that you ladies say it's a movement.
It is. It's a movement.
And we want to get it. Go to our website, everybody. We'll link you to all of that information. It's Safer Beauty Bar. Go to abc4.com/GTU. We have to go to break, but I'll